We know that nature perfects her creations and their functions, not through pure stochasticity or noise alone, but through randomness of a different kind called chaos, generated by non-linearity. Thus, from the distribution of stars in the galaxies to the firing of neurons in the brain, the underlying dynamics and interactions are non-linear, and they give rise to a diverse range of emergent dynamics leading to various functions and phenomena in such systems. We, the complex systems group at IISER Pune, try to understand some of the intricacies of these dynamics. We want to characterize their complexity and look for possible ways of controlling and monitoring their dynamics for beneficial purposes. For this, we use the framework of synchronization in coupled systems, time series analysis, and complex networks. Our future projects in this direction are based on interacting networks and their characterization, complex systems with coupled slow and fast dynamics, control of dynamics in networks, complexity and connectivity measures, and networks generated from time series. We are interested in applying these to astrophysical objects like variable stars and physiological data like ECG, and study of directed networks to understand the progress of Alzheimer's disease. Nonlinear systems are known to exhibit chaotic behavior with sensitive dependence on initial conditions, leading to long-term unpredictability. But with proper coupling, two such systems can synchronize their dynamics. In this context, we have recently introduced a novel coupling scheme where the information needed from the driving system is minimal and intermittent, still can synchronize two chaotic systems. We make this possible by having a variable delay in the coupling with reset, such that the coupling function has the same value in one reset interval. Later, we have shown that this can be used for secure communication in a bi-channel scheme. In fact, this will be much more secure than conventional schemes, since only intermittent data passes through the channel. Real-world systems are complex with many interacting units operating at varied levels of complexity. But such systems are never isolated, they are in interaction with their environment. So recently we looked into the effects of environment in the dynamics of such systems and how environment can induce new emergent phenomena in such systems. We showed that indirect coupling through environment or an external system can lead to antiphase and in-phase synchronization in chaotic systems. If such systems are also connected directly, then suppression of dynamics or amplitude death can happen. This is now established as a new mechanism for occurrence of amplitude death in coupled systems. By studying various types of network topologies, we could show that there is a universal relation for onset of this phenomenon in complex networks, which happens due to interaction with the environment. Our method of environment coupling has picked up and soon applied in several contexts by several research groups. Later, we developed this into a general method for suppression of dynamics and control of spatio-temporal dynamics, and established the same for discrete dynamics on a lattice. Also, this scheme provides a model for real-world phenomena. For example, the dynamics of coupled neurons, which are affected by extracellular medium through what is known as ephaptic coupling. Here, we see how the spatio-temporal dynamics get suppressed when the coupling with the external medium is switched on. Moreover, we could show that chimera states and propagation of undesirable excited waves due to defect neurons can be controlled by the same technique. In an attempt to model the dynamics of dengue infection, we developed a microepidemics model with a few novel features. In primary dengue infection, we introduced two time delays in the dynamics to take care of complex processes and multiple steps involved in the production of antibodies. In secondary dengue infection, we introduced a dynamic switch that accounts for the antibody-dependent virus production and a correlation parameter that measures the similarity between the different serotypes. We could explain the increased antibody counts observed clinically during secondary dengue infection. We have recently completed an extensive work on a typical time delay system called a Mackey-Glass system. Here, we used a different type of coupling called a feedback coupling in a ring of systems with an added delay in coupling. In this setup, the interplay between the different time scales give rise to many emergent phenomena such as isochronous and phase in-phase synchronization, anti-phase synchronization, amplitude death, phase-locked cluster states and splay states. To pursue further our interest in the effect of differing time scales, we have recently started a project on coupled systems with slow and fast dynamical time scales. We could see that as the number of slow systems increases in a network of systems, the systems find it impossible to adjust to the different time scales and therefore settle to a state of no dynamics or amplitude death. As a mechanism underlying the growth of networks, we propose an important property for the nodes which we call mediating capacity, that is generic to many networks. This capacity decreases with increase in the degree, making hubs weak mediators in the process. Interestingly, this prevents explosion of links in the network and makes the network stable. This mediating capacity is an attribute of nodes and comes out as the potential reason for simultaneous occurrence of scale-free nature, high clustering and hierarchical community structure in complex networks. In addition, the same property when combined with mixing by age can explain the associative nature that is observed in the context of social networks. Under the ongoing DST DAD project, we study the interesting possibilities and various cross topologies in interacting networks. We apply them to social networks, climate data networks, transport and transmission networks. As another direction in the study of networks, we have started work in directed networks where we look at the interesting problem of how networks break down due to loss of connections or links. This can happen due to external influences such as attacks, damages or due to specific disease conditions. We find an interesting application for this in understanding Alzheimer's disease, where we will be using actual experimental measurements on loss of spines and synapses done by our collaborators in the Center for Neuroscience in Bangalore. Natural systems are highly complex with a complicated underlying dynamics involving a large number of variables. Hence, studies related to their dynamics most often rely on a sequence of observations or data of a few variables. From such time series, we have to detect non-trivial structures and characterize them for a proper understanding of their underlying dynamics. Recently, we have developed an algorithm for computing measures like correlation dimension, entropy, and multifractal measures that fix the geometric complexity of the reconstructed attractor from the time series. Our study has established that the complexity can be captured completely by a minimal set of four parameters computed from the multifractal spectrum. Now, we plan to look at the observational data from a variety of variable stars with a view to understand the nature of their dynamics, new possible classification schemes, etc. With a lot of data now available from satellite-based observations on a very large number of such objects, we are really excited about the prospects of this study. Also, as another interesting and useful application, we plan to use the theoretical framework developed by us to a large number of ECG data sets. We claim that these four parameters, alpha 1 and 2 and gamma 1 and 2, will provide a quantitative measure that can discriminate between healthy and diseased cases of heart. This will be useful in dynamics as well as in therapy. So soon this can become a standard and routine technique to assist cardiologists to make precise and quantified statements. So the next time you visit your cardiologist, you will get the alphas and gammas of your ECG in addition to the usual clinical tests. Let us look forward to those days. Thank you.